This is the Philips 55POS901F. It is Philips' first OLED TV. It was announced at the end of 2016, but it's come out this year, so it goes head to head with the latest 2017 OLEDs, such as the Sony A1. As it was made in 2016, it is slightly outdated by the latest standards, but the Philips does have one thing really going for it, and that's price. It's £2,500, which is cheaper than any OLED being released in 2017. Additionally, Philips is really focusing on its premium design message. While most designs seem to be heading towards minimalism these days, Philips seems to have doubled down on accessories. There's a lot of metal going on in the frame and the feet, and there's a big soundbar right there. That's got six speakers in there, alongside an additional three-ring speaker plus an integrated subwoofer at the back. Now, Philips does tend to focus more on sound, and it pays off because this thing sounds a lot better out of the box compared to a lot of TVs. Beneath the soundbar, you've got the clawed feet on either side of the screen. They're very wide apart, and I'm not a huge fan of that because it means you need a very wide bench to sit it on. I much prefer central pedestal stands or the TVs that give you adjustable feet, but at least in this case, it's quite stable. So, you know, you can shake the TV a bit and it's stable for its size. Philips' party trick is Ambilight, and this OLED is one of the latest to get the Ambilight treatment. Now, basically, there are LEDs on the edges of the TV, and they project light around the TV so that there's a bit of a halo effect going on. The idea is that what you watch is going to project beyond the borders of your TV onto your walls. It's supposed to aid immersion, and it's also supposed to give you the sense that the TV you're watching is bigger than it actually is. You can change the settings so that it will follow the picture around, or you can choose that it will highlight a single color. In this case, we've gone for Trusted Reviews Orange. I find it a little bit distracting when I'm watching a film to have the halo moving around, but I think it's really good for when you're gaming. Regardless of those, it's very nice when you're watching in a dark room to have this halo of light because it's easier on the eyes. As for the picture itself, this is a 2016 OLED panel, which means it'll get up to about 650 nits of peak brightness, which is lower than what Sony and LG and Panasonic are offering this year. They're boasting about 1000 nits. This has a 4K resolution and it supports high dynamic range in the HDR10 format. There's no Dolby Vision, although at least Philips has announced this will be getting an update to support Hybrid Log Gamma. On the software front, this runs Android TV. It runs on the latest version of Android Marshmallow. Now, sadly, it's a bit sluggish, it's not very well optimized, and I'm not a big fan of the settings section that Philips has put in on top. It's a bit confusing. But at least being a Google system, there are some things that are consistent with other Android TVs. You've got Chromecasting, which is very handy, and you've got Netflix and Amazon apps built in. I mentioned that this is an LG OLED panel, and you might be wondering why you shouldn't just go and buy an LG OLED TV, considering in 2017, a lot of last year's TVs are very heavily discounted. Well, it's not just the panel that matters, the picture processing counts as well. And Philips has added its own processing on top, which drastically improves the default performance by the LG panel. Motion is more stable, grayscale management is better, it's more subtle in handling shades of color, both in light scenes and dark scenes. And it's also noticeably sharper than LG's TVs from 2016. Compared with the latest TVs, well, the latest OLEDs are brighter. So the Sony A1, for instance, manages about 1000 nits peak brightness. And it's not only brighter, it manages to capture more detail in the brighter areas. As for LCDs, well, Samsung is currently boasting a peak of about 2000 nits, which is comfortably brighter than the 650 or so that this TV can achieve. If you're looking for high dynamic range impact, you're not going to find as much here. But I've already mentioned the price. This thing is £2,500, which is easily cheaper than any of the top-end TVs out in 2017. As for LCD, Samsung's Q7 is slightly cheaper at £2,300, but that doesn't manage the perfect blacks that this OLED can. So all in all, if you're not trying to catch the latest specs and you want the best OLED TV to come out of 2016, and also you're interested in the Ambilight function, then this is the one for you.